Namaste. Myself, Dr. Basaraj M. Biradar, Assistant Professor, Department of Humanities and Sciences, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Now, in this video, I explain the inverse Laplace transform by convolution theorem. Learning outcomes. At the end of this session, student will be able to find the inverse Laplace transform using convolution theorem. Convolution theorem statement: if L inverse of f of s is equal to f of t and L inverse of g of s is equal to g of t, then L inverse of f of s into g of s is equal to integration u is equal to 0 to t f of u into g of t minus u into du. Working procedure for problems. Step 1. The given equation is expressed as the product of the two functions f of s and g of s. In the step 2, we find L inverse of f of s is equal to f of t and L inverse of g of s is equal to g of t. And in step 3, we apply the convolution theorem, that is L inverse of f of s into g of s is equal to integration u is equal to 0 to t f of u into g of t minus u into du. And in step 4, we evaluate the integral to obtain the required inverse Laplace transform. Pause the video and answer the question. Find the inverse Laplace transform of number 1, s upon s squared plus 4, and number 2, 1 upon s minus 3. I hope all of you have written the answer. Answer. First one, L inverse of s upon s squared plus 4 is equal to cos 2t, because L inverse of s upon s squared plus e squared is equal to cos 8t. And second one is L inverse of 1 upon s minus 3 is equal to e to the power 3t, because L inverse of 1 upon s minus a is equal to e to the power 8t. Here a is equal to 3. Come to an example. Use the convolution theorem, find the inverse Laplace transform of 1 upon s squared into s minus a. Solution. Let 1 upon s squared into s minus a can be split as the product of the two functions, that is 1 by s squared into 1 upon s minus a. Let f of s is equal to 1 by s squared and g of s is equal to 1 upon s minus a. Now further, to find the f of t and g of t, that is the f of t is equal to L inverse of f of s, which is equal to L inverse of 1 by s squared is equal to t, and g of t is equal to L inverse of g of s, which is equal to L inverse of 1 upon s minus a, which is equal to e to the power a t. Now, by the convolution theorem, we know that L inverse of f of s into g of s is equal to integration u is equal to 0 to t f of u into g of t minus u into du. Therefore, L inverse of 1 upon s squared into s minus a is equal to integration u is equal to 0 to t, and replacing in f of t, t by u, that is, it becomes u. And in g of t, t by t minus u, that becomes e to the power a into t minus u, that is u into e to the power a into t minus u into du. Therefore, L inverse of 1 upon s squared into s minus a is equal to integration u is equal to 0 to t. By replacing the f of t, t by u, and g of t by t minus u, it becomes u into e to the power a into t minus u into du. Therefore, the L inverse of 1 upon s squared into s minus a is equal to integration u is equal to 0 to t u into e to the power a t into e to the power of minus a u, by using the law of indices here. Now, when you are integrating with respect to u, means t is treated as constant, take this e to the power a t as a outside the integral sign, that is equal to e to the power a t into integration u is equal to 0 to t into u into e to the power of minus a u into du. On integrating the Bernoulli integration by parts, that is L inverse of 1 upon S squared into S minus A is equal to e to the power AT into, now here the first function U as the first function and e to the power minus AU as a second function. Now according to Bernoulli integration by parts, the first function as it is, that is U as it is, and integration of e to the power of minus AU is e to the power of minus AU by minus A minus derivative of first in the preceding, the derivative of U with respect to U is 1, and integration of second term in the preceding, that is e to the power of minus AU by minus A, minus A into minus A, that is plus A squared, between the limits 0 to T. Now substituting the lower, now substituting the upper minus lower limit, and that is equal to e to the power AT into, substituting upper limit it becomes minus T into e to the power of minus AT by A minus A minus e to the power of minus AT by A squared plus, when substituting the lower limit, the first term becomes 0 and minus it becomes plus e to the power 0 is equal to 1 upon A squared. That therefore, L inverse of 1 upon S squared into S minus A is equal to e to the power AT by A squared after multiplying this e to the power AT. That is, multiply the entire term by e to the power AT and then simplifying, the L inverse of 1 upon S squared into S minus A is equal to e to the power AT by A squared minus T by A minus 1 upon A squared. Now come to another example. Find the inverse Laplace transform of S upon S plus 2 into S squared plus 9 by convolution theorem. Solution: S upon S plus 2 into S squared plus 9 can be split as a product of the two function, that is 1 upon S plus 2 into S upon S squared plus 9. Let f of S is equal to 1 upon S plus 2 and g of s is equal to s upon s squared plus 9. Now find the f of t and g of t. That is, f of t is equal to l inverse of f of s, which is equal to l inverse of 1 upon s plus 2 is equal to e to the power of minus 2t. And g of t is equal to l inverse of g of s is equal to l inverse of s upon s squared plus 9 is equal to cos 3t. Now, by the convolution theorem, we know that L inverse of f of s into g of s is equal to integration u is equal to 0 to t f of u into g of t minus u into du. That is, L inverse of s upon s plus 2 into s squared plus 9 is equal to integration u is equal to 0 to t and replacing the f of t by u and in g of t by t minus u, then it becomes the e to the power of minus 2u into cos 3 into t minus u into du, and that is equal to integration u is equal to 0 to t e to the power of minus 2u into cos of 3t minus 3u into du. For the integration purpose, we know that the integration of e to the power ax into cos bx into dx is equal to e to the power ax upon a squared plus b squared into a cos bx plus b sin bx here. Now, using that formula, the integration becomes e to the power of minus 2u upon minus 2 squared plus bracket minus 3 whole squared into minus 2 into cos 3t minus 3u minus 3 into sin 3t minus 3u between the limits 0 to t. And substituting the upper and lower limit, it becomes 1 upon 13 e to the power of minus 2t into minus 2 into cos 0 minus 3 into sin 0 minus of e to the power of 0 minus 2 into cos 3t minus 3 into sin 3t, which is equal to 1 by 13 into e to the multiply this by e to the power of minus 2t. That becomes the minus 2 into e to the power of minus 2t, because cos 0 is equal to 1 plus sin 0 is equal to 0, it is equal to 0, and then e to the power 0 is equal to 1, minus into minus, it become plus 2 into cos 3t plus 3 into sin 3t. Therefore, L inverse of S upon S plus 2 into S squared plus 9 is equal to 1 by 13 into 2 cos 3t plus 3 sin 3t minus 2 e to the power minus 2t. Reference. Thank you.